If you've been watching the news this last couple of days, you've probably seen headlines like this. The housing boom is officially over, according to Yahoo Finance. CNN saying home sales drop in June as prices continue to rise. And CNBC declaring pending home sales drop in June, more evidence of a housing turnaround. Let's talk about some actual data and let's see what's really happening in the marketplace. I'm Sandy Warner with Warner Realty Group, and today we're going to talk about some concerns that lots of you have expressed to me, especially if you're looking for investment properties or looking for vacation homes or second family homes. As you saw in that first slide, we're definitely seeing the news starting to talk about the drop in a drop in home sales. And what those are referring to is this next slide I'm going to pop up here for you. And this is called, this is the existing home sales. So the existing home sales is a report that is put out every month by NAR. And NAR is the National Association of Realtors. And existing home sales is a recording that is compiled every month of all the sales that closed. And it really only records anything that was a deed recorded through a property records office. As you can see, if we look at, you can see there's a dotted line that says June and it's in yellow. And you can kind of see where June is all the way over on the right. We don't have July's numbers yet. So at the bottom, you can see this is starting in, I think it's January of 2014. And it's kind of, you know, up and down and up and down. You see that big dip over on the right? That was when the country was closed in May of 2020, April and May of 2020. And everything came to a screeching halt. And then you see this massive increase in home sales that went up through all the way through last January and February. And now we're coming back down and we're having a little bit of a dip. And then we came back up again at the end of June. So yes, did home sales drop off? They sure did. But in relation to the historical data, not really that much other than this big burst we had. So existing home sales is a data point that looks backwards. Let's look forward. Let's see what's happening coming up. The next report I'm going to pull up for you is, this is a slide that also came from NAR, which is the National Association of Realtors. And this is viewing actual buyer traffic. And the map that you see in front of you is from April of 2021. So the key, if you can read the key, the dark code, the dark blue, which we're seeing mostly on this map, says very strong. And then the lighter blue is strong. And then if it was white, that would be stable. So in April, the map is mostly dark blue. In May, we can see it coming from dark blue to lighter blue in parts of the country, sort of the mid-Atlantic there, West Virginia, well, actually south of the mid-Atlantic, up in Minnesota, Alaska went from very strong to strong. And then in June, we see about 50-50, right? Half of the country is very strong and half of the country is strong. Now I'm going to put these all up side by side for you so you can see all three maps together. This is the second quarter of 2021, and we did see it go from very strong in the majority of the country. Now it's down to strong to very strong in the entire part of in the entire country. So we're still at strong and very strong. And this is buyer traffic. And buyer traffic is a leading indicator of what home sales are going to do. Another indicator, if you have followed me, you may have seen this slide. Showing time is a product that many MLSs in the country use, and it's a way of setting appointments to see homes. So showing time is a good indicator of how many people are going to see homes. And again, we're going to use June of 2021 because we don't have July's data yet. We'll use June of 2021 to kind of see where we are historically. So yes, we were way up in March and April, right? We were way over historic norms. But when we look at it coming down in May, it's still at where it was, which are was historic highs, and June is still above historic highs. So yes, it's slowing down, but it's slowing down from that hurly-burly pace that it was, not from historic norms. So the next thing I want to show you here, this is really what we're going to talk about here. And this is the biggest concern that my clients have. And I think everyone that's buying property right now. I work with a lot of investors, a lot of second time or third time home buyers, lots of first, really everybody. One of the biggest concerns that buyers have right now is they're going to buy a home and their home's going to lose depreciation. And this number validates that concern. This is the May 2020, 2021 year over year appreciation numbers as reported by three different agencies. The first one, the Federal Housing Finance Agency or the FHFA, reported that from May of 2020 to May of 2021, homes in the United States appreciated 18%. 18%. The CoreLogic report, the Home Price Insights report, pegged that at 15%. And the S&P Case-Shiller pegged it at 16%. So you're not imagining this. Prices are going sky high. Your home, if you bought in May of 2020, you have an appreciation of somewhere between 15 and 18% if these numbers are correct. And they probably are. There are variations in how it's reported and what factors are taken into account, but you had great appreciation. So your question to me is, well, if I buy now, if I buy in July or August of 2021, well, it's August now, will I lose value on my home? Is that appreciation going to stop? According to Lawrence Yoon, who's the chief economist for the National Association of Realtors, and I'm just going to read you what he said. Given that sales activities are slowing down, and we saw that in the second slide, they're slowing down. They're basically going from 9,000 miles an hour to 8,000 miles an hour. Given that sales activities are coming down, we may be sensing some turn in the market. We are seeing less prevalence of multiple offers, but it's still a seller's market, no doubt. Still a seller's market, but people need to be very cautious. This is going to you, sellers, even though this is maybe geared more towards our buyers. Sellers need to be cautious on how they price their home to attract buyers, knowing that these sales activities are declining somewhat. I'm going to leave you with one last piece of information. If you are thinking about buying in this market and you're worried that you're buying at the top of the market and the prices are going to decline, we're just not seeing data to support that. And I posted on my Instagram earlier. If you see my Instagram, it's the realtor, the broker.sandy. The projection for interest rates are to go to 3.3 next summer or 3.8 next summer. We're not going to see a big increase in interest rates. And right now we're still seeing a very strong seller's market. If you look at this chart that's in front of you, a buyer's market is when we have more than 7 months of inventory. That means there's more inventory than buyers. A neutral market is when we have 6 to 7 months of inventory. And a seller's market is when we have less than 6 months of inventory. And yes, we have a smidge more inventory, but we've only just come off the low that we were experiencing. So if you see today, we've just come off that little bit of a low, which was a super strong seller's market. When we have a seller's market, the sellers hold all the cards because there are too few properties for the number of buyers that want the properties. And that really isn't changing that much. So there are fewer buyers out there. It might be due to buyer fatigue. You guys have been working really hard, putting in offers, and it's a struggle and you're having to do it 2, 3, and 4 times and you're losing your offers. So buyers are being more cautious, but there's no more inventory. And, you know, demand, supply drives demand. And if there's no homes, it just keeps the prices up really high. So yes, super, super hard to buy homes right now, but there's no data supporting that you are in any risk of losing appreciation if you buy a home right now. So let's focus on the real data. Data, no drama. I'm Sandi Warner with Warner Realty, making the complex simple.